Seyon, hi, good afternoon. How are you?
Hi, Ilyas. I'm good. Yeah, how are you?
I'm fine. I'm holding up. Is tket a tool primarily for the machine builders, for the people who are building quantum processors, or is it really primarily a tool for the end user, the customer?
It's a tricky one to answer that one, because in some sense, by doing one, you kind of get the other for free. Especially because we've always made a point of being machine agnostic and supporting as many different devices and backends as we can. So I can definitely say it's very attractive to the application developer, because that is, in terms of a user, that is who we see as our user, someone who wants to develop quantum applications that can exploit the power of tket to do so. But then when you have all these application developers already using tket in conjunction with some other quantum software service that tket plugs into, then if you come along to the scene and want to get your machine out there, if you can have tket support, you immediately have a load of code and a load of developers that can immediately use your machine and make the best use of it without having to move all of their code over or relearn things, a lot of things that aren't interesting to them.
Ultimately, this is all about allowing users to think about programming or using existing programs. What would you like to have been the case that tket has done for the ecosystem and for quantum computing generally?
So I think what I would like it to have done is to have accelerated algorithm development and quantum software development in such a way that when these extremely powerful devices are available, the software is not only, you know, at the base level required to run on it, but has advanced and or has been able to advance so that we immediately start using these devices for solving really, really tricky problems. So that really is what motivates tket in development, because what we're really trying to do is reduce the friction of developing and trying out these algorithms as much as possible. We're trying to make all the boring or hard or all the things you can automate in writing algorithms, make that something that tket handles for you.
Recently, just in terms of looking at application development, there was a paper by the algorithms team at Google that they had and acknowledged that they had used tket in order to achieve whatever the result was. Can you just describe what role tket might have played there? Why would tket, or why might tket have been helpful to that team? Why did they end up using it?
Yeah, so in that particular case, they were trying out an optimizing application on their Sycamore device. And the Sycamore device has a certain fixed connectivity, which means qubits can talk to their four nearest neighbors. But the particular problem they were dealing with had not that restriction. So there were different qubit connectivity requirements. And so this goes back to the routing thing I mentioned earlier. So for this particular application, they needed some software to do the routing for them, especially because they were running a large number of circuits. And so in trying it out, I don't want to speak for them, but I believe what they found was tket offered them the best performance. So they decided to do that, use that to get the best results they could.
And you guys in the team have chosen from early on, not only to be open access, but you've also been open in your publications. You have published empirical data showing performance. Are you guys going to continue to be open about your results and how much better than you are than the competition? Or is this part of the development which will move on and other issues will become more important, for example, other than speed?
So the metrics we really care about is delivering the best performance from the device that we can, or a number of devices. I mean, it's nice to have been to have written something that did the best at that at one given time. But really what we're doing by putting publications out there, it isn't so much about saying we're the best as saying, this is how we did it. It worked quite well. Now please do better, because this is important for the whole field to move forwards. We're quite happy to be open about what we're doing so that and we're quite happy for other people to do the same.
That's reassuring. And in this day and age, Seyon, refreshing. As far as tickets concerned, we've had a number of upgrades and a number of specialist libraries added, for example, in support of quantum chemistry applications. Can you just give us a flavor of a route map over the course of the next, maybe shorter term, the next 12 months, as to what else is on the horizon from that standpoint? I don't mean from the underlying functionality, but the support system. What other applications, areas, industries?
So one of the most exciting things that we've been able to demonstrate with tket in the recent past is because we have an in-house quantum chemistry team, and that's probably going to be one of the first leading applications of quantum computers, we've been able to show that circuit compilation and optimization techniques can be developed that are specific to an application. So for chemistry circuits in particular, we've been able to show that we can optimize those circuits to a far greater degree than we can do for a generic circuit by working in close conjunction with the human team. And this also enables a close software connection between the two pieces of software. So human is, the tket is very tightly baked into human. And this we are in right now, and in the near future we'll be expanding to other fields. So we are now currently working very closely with our quantum machine learning team to do the same there. The next few sort of applications that we'll be focusing on will be optimization related circuits, and hoping to extend that to the finance realm and things like that. Some of the more novel pieces of work we'll be doing will include adding more mitigation functionality. So this is trying to fight the noise levels in the machine by doing some kind of post-processing on your results or running calibrations or things like that. And adding more advanced device characterization functionality and more noise cancellation compilation techniques as well.
Right.